Yeah, listen, it's a game where you'd love to win. There's no two ways about it. And a point that stops that sequence of losing, which is vital for us. We're without big players in that, and it's a lot for us to carry with a young squad. When you lose people that have been taking and Vlad on the court, it's a big chunk for our spine of our team. So I'm pleased it stopped that sequence of losing games. As I said before, we've only been here 17 months or so, whatever it is, whatever the case may be. And I knew the first few years was going to be really, really tough. But we're halfway there. When you look at the table, it's really tight, but we're halfway where you want to get to. So it's a big point.
You got the early goal, it sparked a very big celebration. What was the thinking behind
that? I don't know. The lads, I never knew that was going to happen, and but they're a group that are really close together, and there's a good unity there which you need, and but I never knew that was going to happen.
Disappointed you couldn't capitalize.
Yeah, as I said, Swansea are a good side. They pass the ball really well, but Guzan's not really had many saves, I don't think. Not many saves at all. So, but they're a good side. They're a good passing team, as everybody knows. And they came here and played some nice football. But Guzan, I'd like to be the lads of their effort and their commitment to it, because Guzan never really had that much to do.
Just 3 days rest before you got another back
in. Yeah.
How is the squad looking fitness-wise?
Have you only
made 3 changes today?
So yeah. Well, hopefully we made changes because it was too much for us. We can't carry that overhaul of our turnover. We can't do that. We've got to try and get the best and do the right things. We left lads out because of the game the other day. Hopefully, been taking Vlar will hopefully come back pretty quick. Hopefully there's a good chance. As I said, that's the spine of your team. I think everybody knows when you lose the spine of your team, it can be a big hit. And we're a young side, and we need to grow it. It's developing every time. As I said before, I knew the first couple of years would be pretty hard. And but listen, we're, as I said, 20 points, you're halfway there. And if we can get one or two back, then it'll make you stronger.
Would you like more experience on the team? Would that mean delving into the market in general?
I think the experience that, if you go for experienced players, it costs a lot of money on fees, a lot of money in salaries, all those sort of things. And as I said before, Randy Lerner's been great to me on that front. But if you go down the experience route and it does cost you a lot of money, then you have to see.
Or is that a no?
No, listen, you can never say never. And but I knew the way we had to build the club and get supported by, we're going to have to do it a certain way. And that's what I've done. The lads that have played, the young lads, they're giving me everything they've got in their body. And that's all you can ever ask for. From a group of lads, every time you get into a game, the lads give you everything. As I said, you look at the teams that are down there at the minute, a lot of experienced sides, and we're sitting above them.
What did you make of the performance overall, Paul?
It was hard because, listen, the commitment and the effort, couldn't fault them. As I said before, it's hard. Swansea are a good side as well. But I've seen the lads play some really good games and end up losing. Really good games. And you think, we played really well, then come away with nothing. Some games you have to fight tooth and nail to get something. And they certainly did that. Their commitment to it was really pleasing.
A few boos at the end, was that a bit harsh, do you think?
I think you have to differentiate from what's happened here in the past to the way modern day football is now. The club's got a huge name, it's got a great past, in history, which is fantastic. And you have to try and live up to that. But I'm a million miles from where I want to be, a million miles from it. But I'm building something and trying to develop it and try to make it go in the right direction. So, yeah, listen, I don't think it affected the lads, because the solidarity with them and the unity with them, I think, was there for everybody to see.
You said you didn't know about the celebration,
yeah.
But were you happy about it, and is it a good thing? And
I never knew.
How important getting a goal was after you struggled for them for a while?
Listen, if somebody scores, they can do what they want. As far as I'm concerned, they can do what they want. And the hardest thing in the game is to score. And it was a great goal, great move, and great finish. So, as I said, I never knew they were going to do it. Was I happy about it? I don't really know what they done. Did they run right into
the... Big huddle
of all the behind you, of all the players. Means they're quite close then, doesn't it? Well, yeah. It means they're quite close. So, yeah, they can do it. No, not at all. As I said, halfway through it. And then the table's that tight for everybody that one catapults you up there. And I think the table's so tight at the minute. You look at some of the results today, they're pretty strange, some of them. And no, there's halfway there. I don't think anybody can talk like that.
Paul, you said that you knew the first few years would be really difficult when you came in here.
Mm-hmm.
You're talking about a very long-term plan, aren't you?
That's it, yeah. We have a plan, and we knew. As I said, Randy's been great on that front. Told me the whole crux of it. And I said I have a good relationship with him. Without getting into great detail, we just don't talk about football and all that sort of thing. But I respect... He's the chairman of the football club, but I knew.
Are you where you would have expected to be at this stage of your plan?
I think we're a million miles short from it, as in where I want to go. Yeah, because I think when you do that, especially a club this size, you know that there is a plan and a long road with it. But it's a challenge you relish, and. It's something that I do relish on it.
Paul, what's the situation with Nzokbia at the moment?
He's injured at the minute, and that's another one, yeah.
How far away do you expect
him
to be?
I think Charles is obviously going to go into the new year, obviously, so he could be another little bit, I think, Charles. He had a bad injury, to be fair to him, and so it's his rehab as well that's discontinuing.
There've been a lot of sackings even this week.
Oh Christ!
Brought into the chairman's plan. Do you feel immune from?
No, not at all. Never do. And as I said, I've got a good relationship with them. That doesn't mean, in your words there, that am I immune to it? No. Always have that fear, as you do, and I always had fear when I was a footballer, and I always have fear when I'm a manager. You know, as manager, every other club I've been at, I think you've got to have that little bit of fear in your body. Say that again, sorry. He's been, I don't think it would be any tougher than last year. What happened last year, and he was great with me then, and I spoke to him last night, and he's been good with us as well, and as I said, I have a good, as I say, good relationship with him. But back to the question there, that you're certainly not immune from anything.